I'm Gerry from Gerry's Craft Room, and today's video is another collaboration video with my friend Justine Hovey, who has an amazing channel. And we are both going to share some fun craft hacks that we love and we are very excited to share with you. I have the link to Justine's video in the description box below, so make sure to watch that after you watch my video. So let's check out the hacks. For the first hack, I'm going to use pixie powders and I spray my card on both sides against warping, so it stays flat on my surface. I tap on the bottom of the bottle so a little of the powder comes out. You don't want to squeeze it because then a lot comes out and that will give you enough for 20 cards, and that's maybe a little bit too much. And I just add the two colors randomly. I spray some water to activate the powders even more. I add a little bit more powder and some more water. Just so you know, I've added the main products I used in the description box for you. You can find the full list of supplies on my blog. And if you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe. And then I'm going to add my plastic wrap. I'm going to make lots of folds and creases. The more you get, the more texture you get. And now I can pick up the complete MakeArt station and put it aside so I can let my card dry. After drying, it looks like this. You can just peel off the plastic and there you have lots of lovely shimmery texture. And this is real easy to do. And this is the finished card I made with it. Another hack, embossing with stencils, also a great way to stretch your products. Here I have a card I have embossed, a regular embossing, but I have a little trick to make your impression a little bit deeper. I add two sheets of regular printing paper under my rubber mat, then I add my card, my stencil and the plate, and then I run it through the machine. And this way you will get a deeper impression of your stencil, and it runs through real smoothly, so it's not bad for your machine either. And here you can see the difference with or without using the paper as a shim, and I will come back to this card later. Another fun and easy technique to add some color to your cards is color dipping. I add some ink to my work surface and I'm using Catherine Pooler inks, and then I spray some water and I'm going to dip in the paper. And there you have a nice lovely layer. I'm wiggling a little bit with the paper to let the colors drip from the sides. And I'm also going to blot a little bit to remove the really big color blobs that you don't get these lines on the side. But you can leave that too. That will give you another bit of texture. I dry the card a little bit and then I add more ink. I just dip in again because there's still lots of it on my desk. So here's the first background. I'm adding a second card in the ink that is still left on my desk and I dip it in, and you can still get lots of texture from that too. This gives you a nice watercolor background effect, and you can see this is a real simple and easy way to get some color on your cards. And here are the two first backgrounds. You can also color dip with one color, just add the ink, spray some water and then dip in your paper. And dipping in more, that will give you some layers, and you can dry in between to add to the texture. And there you go, another real easy and pretty background. I have a little trick for those of you who have a MakeArt station. It's very slippery, especially on a very smooth surface. So what I do is I add a microfiber cloth underneath, and there you go, it won't move anymore and it's steady on your desk. Next is embossed coloring. I'm using the card that I embossed earlier. I'm adding the stencil back in place on the design and then I'm adding it to the MakeArt station with my big magnets. And now I'm going to color. And this is a technique that I did in a previous video, and I've got a bunch of questions about how to keep your sponge applicators in good shape when using a stencil and inking like this. Well, when you emboss your card, the pattern is raised and the paper basically fills the holes in the design, so your sponge applicator reaches the paper easier. This way your sponge applicators don't get damaged that easy. Another way that you can protect your sponge applicators while inking like this is to don't press too hard. So just slide over your stencil softly. Don't press, don't try to push your sponge applicator in the holes, because then you will certainly damage your sponge applicators, which is such a waste because you can use them over and over if you take care of them. I've added the color first to the flowers and then to the rest of the card, and this way you can make the pattern stand out a bit more. Here you can see the sponge applicator still in good condition. And now I'm inking the edges. To me, this gives a really nice finish to a card, so I like inking the edges like this. I have another video where I use the same colors ink in a few different ways. I will link to that at the top, so you can check that out too if you like. And here's the finished card and another one I did in the same way. Here's another fun technique. I'm building on a previous technique, so I embossed the card again. I'm adding it back to the stencil and adding it back on the platform. And now I'm going to use Distress Micro Glaze. It has a bit of a feel like Vaseline, but it's a little bit thicker. It was designed to seal Distress products, so you can add more layers. But it will also work great as a resist, so adding it through a stencil with a sponge applicator like this will give you a really great background and a really fun effect, because you can add a next layer and the places where you added the paste will act as a resist. So the paste doesn't show really well, but you will see it in a bit because I'm going to add some sprays. I added my card in a box and now I'm adding the sprays and you can already see the pattern appear. I just spray some color all over the background and then I'm adding it back to my make art station and I'm blotting a little bit of the drops and I'm going to let it dry. Where the pattern is, it's still feeling a little bit waxy, greasy, so I'm buffing it to remove the bits of micro glaze that are on top of the card and it feels like regular paper again. I did another background in the same way and here are the cards I made with them. And now some double-sided adhesive hex. I have double-sided adhesive and a piece of card that's the same size. And I'm going to add my card on the double-sided adhesive without any excess sticking out. I fold the corner of the backing of the double-sided adhesive. I add my card on top of the paper backing and all the corners. And then I press on the sticky corner and pull out the paper from under while I rub the card on the double-sided adhesive. And this way you get your paper straight on. Another trick I use all the time is with double-sided adhesive. I like to add my cards or my backgrounds on cards with double-sided adhesive. And I have shown this trick in lots of videos, but I always get comments how handy this is, so I wanted to share it in this video too. I fold the corners of the backing of the double-sided adhesive and I like the thin kind that you can tear because it's easier and less work. Then I add my background to my card, I put it in place and I press down the corners and then I check if it's straight. And if it's right in place, then you can peel away the backing strips and voila, there you have your card on straight. My last hack is using glossy accents as a glue for non-porous surfaces to add it to a porous surface or another non-porous surface. I'm going to use the embellishment wand and a skewer to pick up little bits of the glossy accents. This gives me a bit more control than when using the bottle straight on the paper. I pick up the crystals and add a little bit of the glossy accents and press the crystals in, and that way they will stick to the card and stay there. So here's the finished card and here's another card with crystals added in the same way. I hope you enjoyed my craft hacks. Make sure to hop on over to Justine's channel to watch hers. And don't forget to give my video a thumbs up, to share and to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And as always, and now even more than ever, build in some me time and make sure to keep on crafting.